Viewers, now I am going to discuss on another important viral disease of dog. Of course, you consider distemper, parvo, etc. It is not that much prevalent. Still then, it is prevalent and it causes or it affects the intestinal tract of the dog, causing gastroenteritis similar to parvovirus. It is a very contagious virus affecting not only the pups but also older dog. I want to emphasize upon the owner with the point that nowadays there is pandemic of coronavirus infection in human beings. But the virus that affects the human being and the virus that affects the dog is not same. So, coronavirus disease of dog will not affect the human being. That virus is a separate component, right? And therefore, one should not be afraid that my dog is suffering corona and that may spread the corona to the human beings, right? That apprehension should not be there. Dog's coronavirus is absolutely a virus for the dog or canine population, right? But there is some saying that it may affect the human beings, but actually there is no firm evidence about that. So infection generally occurs through material contaminated by feces, right? Contaminated by the feces infected with your coronavirus. It can occur when dogs smell or lick the ground where the feces is there. Coronavirus is shed in the feces of infected dogs for months after initial ingestion. That means it harbors for a long period of time. Dogs at highest risk for infections, those are unvaccinated, right? Unvaccinated puppies or those that have not completed their vaccine schedule may suffer. Dogs of all ages can be infected, but incidence is more in pups and younger age group of animals. Unsanitary and overcrowded kennels or where the dogs remain in close together, there is increased incidence of the disease or increased chance of infection and concurrent infection. Sometimes concurrent infection with parasites. If a dog already harboring some endoparasites or internal parasites, then the infection will be more. Right? Concurrent infection with parasites or virus, other virus or bacteria, they will create a vicious problem or vicious circles leading to greater type of infection. The primary signs associated with coronavirus infection is coronaviral diarrhea. Diarrhea tends to be less profuse than associated with parvovirus infection. If you consider the parvovirus diarrhea and the coronavirus diarrhea, the direct rate in coronavirus infection is less, whereas parvovirus it is profuse. So it is less profuse in coronavirus infection rather than parvovirus infection. It causes milder diarrhea than parvovirus. And if you want to differentiate these two, we have got the kit. With the help of kit on the laboratory, we can differentiate the disease. Both parvovirus and coronavirus cause similar type of diarrhea. Odor is also more or less identical. Signs of coronavirus are similar to parvovirus, so that initial diagnostic test is likely to include parvovirus test to rule out the presence of this virus. So we'll have to differentiate the parvovirus or parvoviral diarrhea and coronavirus diarrhea with the help of the parvo kit, right? So diarrhea is a cardinal signs of both the diseases, right? And the diarrheic stools are more or less similar in both the diseases. But here in parvovirus infection, diarrhea is profuse, and in case of coronavirus infection, diarrhea is less, not profuse. For definite diagnosis, one has to go in the laboratory for isolation and identification, right? It is possible only in specialized virus laboratory, which general practitioners may not have the opportunity to such test. One has to depend on symptoms. And the peculiarity is that in parvovirus infection, I have told you that vomition is the cardinal signs along with the diarrhea. But in coronavirus infection, you may not get vomition, only diarrhea. This is the differentiation. Here you may not get vomition, seldom vomition, but diarrhea is there. But in parvovirus, vomition is more, diarrhea is also there, and profuse vomition, and vomition may cause dehydration leading to anhydramnia, right? Ribavulvic shock. And this differentiation has to be kept in mind. Diagnosis, if you want to make diagnosis, it is not fatal like parvovirus infection, rarely fatal. If you can give symptomatic treatment, it may survive. Chance of survival is more in case of coronavirus infection rather than parvovirus infection, right? So it is rarely fatal. And most of the practitioners, they diagnose corona based on typical clinical signs, ruling out other causes of gastroenteritis, such as intestinal obstruction, negative parvo test, right? So it is not difficult to diagnose such cases. So complete medical history and physical examination will do. Blood test one has to do, stool examination, abdominal X-ray may help in determining the severity of infection or exclude other causes. Therapy is dependent upon the severity of clinical signs. But again, I tell you, if you want to treat such cases, then one has to think that it is a diarrheic patient. Forget about corona. It is a diarrheic patient. So therefore, fluids and electrolytes has to be given. Fluid and electrolyte is the only thing. Since vomition is not there, we may not think of that antacid treatment. In that way, we can forget about that. We go for the diarrheic treatment. We have to make the loose stool thick or loose stool to a normal shape. And that is possible only through fluid and electrolyte therapy and some antibiotic treatment. Gut-acting antibiotic have to be given. Gut-acting antibiotic has to be given. But if you find that it is having nausea and vomition, in that case, we will have to go for treatment of nausea and vomition. Otherwise, mainly we will be thinking of how to stop diarrhea, how to prevent dehydration. Dehydration is the main cause of death, and therefore that has to be done. And sometimes, if you cannot do in intravenous subcutaneous, if you give the subcutaneous injection also, that may also do, right? So coronavirus infection is to some extent milder than parvovirus infection, where main manifestation is diarrhea. And if you want to prevent it, so prevention means avoid dog-to-dog contact. That means physical distance has to be maintained, right? If there is a contact between the two dogs, there is chance of infection. And not only the dog, avoid the contact with the object, those are contaminated with the feces, right? Utensils and other things, other materials. So we should not come in contact with those substances, those materials. From there also infection may occur. Crowding, overcrowding, that's why I have told you physical distance, dirty facilities, grouping large number of dogs in one place, and stress may cause outbreak of the disease. There may be coronavirus outbreak, right? And so far the protection is concerned, vaccine is the answer. So coronaviral inactivated vaccines which are available should be given to the puppies against coronavirus infection. This coronavirus vaccine is not that much important in case of adult animal. Adult vaccine in adult animal is not required. May not be required, but puppy has to be given coronavirus infection. Thank you.
Jodi apnader amader ei channel ti bhalo lage, tahole subscribe korun ebong share korun.